Jata siyezi karanga, uwe hae, shagala bagala. Niko tayari kulipa garama, sita simama maovu ya kitawala. Sita simama maovu ya kitawala. Ufisadi, ubinafsi, ukabila, kuuza sura wataki kuuza sera. Undugu ni kufaana, sita simama.
The ELNET business group was established. This was among the four groups that we have today. One of it is ELNET business group. The next one is the governance group, which is represented here. The other one is the wealth creation group, and the other one is the mentorship group. We started off with the idea of looking through to see what can we do. So we decided to say both are actually important, because it's one times a number times another one to give us the result that we're looking for. So initially we thought, is it one plus one? No, it's one times something. So that if it's zero on one, then the total result is zero. So we are inviting you therefore into these 2 days to basically see, network, listen to what we say. God will help us to transform ourselves even as we seek to transform both where we are working as individuals and the industries that we represent. ELNET finally again is led by a group of volunteers. These are people who work in various institutions. And then each of the four committees are headed by different people. So otherwise, thank you very much, and please feel welcome.
So could we have you, Governor, just address us today?
As I was invited to this forum, I told a number of my people, please join me, just in case I'm pushed into a forest, go back and report. So can I ask my team to stand for to be seen? Thank you very much. Get seated. The organizers of this important conference, invited guests, all other distinguished guests present, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure to have been invited to address this conference, and especially as a keynote speaker. The task bestowed on me in this conference can only be compared to asking a man to climb a ladder that is leaning on him. But also allow me to recognize that this invitation is a great honor to me, first because the efforts my family has made over the years in the running of our business has captured the attention of people far away from where we live and have recognized our positive contribution to society. In a society where negative politics and corruption have taken center stage, nothing brings fresh air than the feeling that in the midst of this confusion, there is still hope for our society. Ladies and gentlemen, my parents were laborers in a farm owned by a white settler allowed on Karau, Nyandarua County, where they did all sorts of manual labor. I attended a school in Nyeri County, where I lived with my grandparents. I'd only joined my parents and brothers and sisters only during some holidays. Having performed well in primary school, I was admitted at Kagumo High School, but my education appeared uncertain for lack of school fees. My parents could not raise a mere 400 shillings school fees required for a whole year. After a long struggle, I secured a bursary from the Nyandarua County Council and was able to sit for my O-level examination and passed, but my burning desire to fight poverty told me to secure a job and abandon further studies. However, my school headmaster, the Reverend Douglas Merwich, could hear none of this, and he literally dragged me back to class to continue with the studies in Form 5 and 6. That is how I joined the University of Nairobi, then University College, to pursue a bachelor's course, degree course on commerce, which I completed in 1970. After trying my hard in government and private sector jobs, first as a college lecturer, then an accountant, I rose through the ranks to become a chief accountant. Eventually, I abandoned salaried employment, and my wife and I started the Nehru Elite Schools in 1980. We have gone through many challenges over the last 4 years since we founded this institution, but suffice it to say that Nehru Elite Schools that offer ECD, primary and secondary education, is among the most successful private schools in Kenya and in Africa today. I have also been a farmer, having undertaken small-scale horticultural farming in Orkrau, as well as dairy farming. I'm proud to report that at one time, my dairy cows attracted a high price during an annual agricultural assessment undertaken in Central Province. And my Minister of Agriculture is the one who came for that assessment, and I'm with her here. Nothing has come easy. The success my family celebrates today is a result of dedication to hard work, personal integrity, commitment to duty, and an unmeasured level of sacrifice. Even as I pray, God help me in my daily work. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe strongly that if the spirit of hard work, commitment, and honesty could be exemplified in the public sector, then Kenya could be in the league of the Asian Tigers. Being a politician now, I cannot leave the podium before saying a word about political leadership, not just in Kenya, but Africa as a whole. In terms of natural resources, but the poorest people has the poorest people on earth. This vision is unacceptable and must be reversed. During a recent leaders' conference organized by the African Forum on Religion and Government, participants identified the maladies facing Africa. Chief among them, the desire by the leaders to be idolized through sycophancy by the followers who hardly speak, enhancing the culture of corruption, inefficiency, and nepotism. The net effect of this is inept and failed leadership, for which we have glaring examples across. And when I was a young man, because now I think I'm old, I used to interact with the father of one of you in many church sessions, and none other but the father to Dr. Kirohe. Thank you.
All right, I think we'll take quite a number of questions so that he doesn't have to keep on standing up for each and every question, and I can see him writing down. I think he's an educator.
The question always is, in the public sector especially, very difficult to maintain an ethical practice. What is the secret for all of us? What secret can you share with us to be able to maintain our ethical practice in all that we do?
How do you balance politics and ethics? Because you have to be affiliated one way or another.
The first one is simple. The issue of investing in Nyandarua, let me say, is that the market is very open. As you have heard, we are trying to transform our county to be the land of milk and potatoes. I'm not slighting honey. I think if we add potatoes, the taste will be sweeter. We have an opportunity in investment in tourism, investment in the what I've talked about, the issue of milk, the issue of potatoes, and the market is limited as of now. We also wanted to renovate and change the. Some of you must have read the books on this, the Happy Valley. We want to cut price on that, revisit the buildings that were well known to the white man, and since they have left relatives wherever they are, and their communication network has already been improved, we want to go through the website and inform them that the Happy Valley is still there for them to come and see what their grandparents used to enjoy. I don't know which is the best method, but personally I've adopted one where wherever I start in public, I start by confessing Christ as my personal savior.
In any public rally, I do the same. So that I believe once I put the shield of Christ on my chest, the arrows of the devil will not be able to penetrate. And that has saved me through the campaign period. Of course, several questions are asked behind my back. I don't have a shield there. But nevertheless, when I turn back, they see the shield and they reduce the tempo.
I pray, Heavenly Father, that you give him good followers, good assistants, people whom he can rely on, oh my Father, to be able to deliver on the mandate that he has, oh Lord, particularly to the people of Nyandarua and even to the larger community in this country. Lord God Almighty, you have heard his vision, the things that he is believing you for the benefit of the people of Nyandarua. I pray, Heavenly Father, that these things will come to pass, that God Almighty, the infrastructure in that county will be sorted out, oh God. We will have good roads, Heavenly Father. Lord God Almighty, that the agricultural practices and the processing plans that are in mind, oh my Father, will be realized, oh God. The Lord, this county will indeed feed not only its people, but feed many other people in this country and even other parts of the world, oh God. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for all the people who have accompanied him to this meeting, oh Lord. I pray, Heavenly Father, that as they go back, you will unite them together in one spirit, so that, Lord, as they work together, they work as a team, oh Lord. Father, protect him in his work, and we pray that all the glory and the honor will come back to you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Sita si mama, mama, uvu ya kitawala.